Hey, so this is the first episode of Nocturnal, where we speak about Heraclitus, we speak about nature, and we speak about a whole bunch of things. Give it a listen. If you want to get in touch, check out the Facebook page. Remember, I'm live every Thursday, 12 a.m. to 1 a.m. Yeah, go listen, UWS Radio, everything's down below. If you like to listen here, give it a listen here. So enjoy, listen your ears up.
What a great song. I do love it. I do love it. It's a great one to start with all the time. I know it just feels it's upbeat, but it's also like nighttime vibes. Speaking of nighttime vibes, some people were getting in touch saying that the picture isn't so nighttime vibes. Yeah, I suppose. Maybe that's the paradoxical state of nocturnal, is that when something is nocturnal, their nighttime is their daytime. I don't know, so it's daytime in the picture because it's daytime for us right now. We're all awake, right? I don't know. That's the only reasoning I can see behind that. Yeah. How are yous all doing? I hope yous are all doing good. You know, last time, I wasn't in last week, so I started... This isn't my first show. This ain't my first rodeo. I do a show with Lewis Main, the lunch hour, 12 to 1 in during the daytime. And then I come back tonight at 12 to 1 and fill your happy people's ears with my voice, with some good music and with some good thoughts, hopefully. And just some good messages, you know, positive vibes whilst we're here. We're all up late. We've all got issues with sleeping schedules, obviously. Or maybe you stayed up to listen to this. Wow, thank you if you have. Thank you. But no, welcome to the show. That's what it's going to be. I don't remember where that whole rant started from. I don't remember, but yeah, we've got some good chat coming up tonight, so I hope you're going to enjoy. But yeah, I was saying that I already did a show before, and the show was good, but it was just improvised with some music, and it wasn't the best. We had our little muck up at the start there. I also forgot to record the beginning of the show with all the music, which is one of my favourite parts of the show. I love the beginning. Oh well, we'll get better with time. I'm going to class this as the first episode. I'm planning to record these and put them up on YouTube as well for you guys, so you can listen back again later. There is a listen again feature on the website, however it's broken at the minute, and I'd like you guys to get access to it and be able to listen to it whether the website is working or not. So I want to give you like this second platform to listen to it on. So I'm hoping to create like a podcast sort of vibe. We're just chilling, peaceful. Oh, can you hear that? What's that? Oh, Minecraft music. Oh, what fun. Yeah, tonight, philosophies. Heraclitus. Okay. Interesting man. Let's begin. Let's begin the sessions here. Interesting man, who believed in this great unity. He was in ancient Greece, which isn't the Greece that we would consider today. It isn't in Greece. He was originally from what we would now call modern Turkey, and he moved over, I think, to Rome. It was south of Italy, and there he started to focus on all his work. And I hope I've not confused him with Pythagoras, but I believe that is right. And so he believed in this thing called Logos, L-O-G-O-S, which has so many interpretations from ancient Greek that no one can really put a finger on what the word means, but we all get a general understanding. You can break it down to logos can be a word, and also the word logical comes from logos, so like a logical word, a truth, essentially. And so this is what Heraclitus believed in. He believed in this logos, which is a unity. It is something like it is settled across the universe, and an order. There's a peace across the universe, almost, that he says. And that peace can be considered the fire. He had this insane obsession with fire throughout his philosophy, saying a load of stuff that we should also take into consideration, because this is what he said. However, it's not as important. It's a bit like it doesn't make sense as much, you know. But he believed that this logos was almost a burning flame, almost the fuel of life. Every soul had it. And the way that you would get this flame in was through the cosmos and through breathing. And breath was the flame. Breath was the logos, but you had the logos inside you. And it was all around. It was just the universe. That's what he believed. Logos is the universe, essentially. The fuel of life. Like it's like burning inside you, almost like a boiler. But what does it genuinely mean? Like what is that unity, I suppose, is a good question. That unity is change itself. For peace to happen, you need change. And I'm going to explain that after the next song, but I'm going to put a song in here. So here you go. We were just speaking about logos. We were speaking about Heraclitus, his logos, his belief in unity, and how unity is essentially change. And it doesn't make sense, like, necessarily straight away when you say that stability and unity is change, because you think that change is moving or whatever, and it's not that stability. However, it does make a lot of sense. It is this, like, it's creating unity by having change. So the first example that I would say that you need to know about with Heraclitus, I keep forgetting his name. Ah, right. We'll get it. the first example I want to speak about is his river idea. And I posted about this on my story before, and a few people were interested, actually. And so he says, you can't step into the same river twice. Which doesn't make much sense when you first hear it, but when you think about it more and think about, well, the water rushes over my feet. There's another quote that suggests that he says about the water rushing over my feet. It's not the same water every time, so it's a different river. It's different water every time, so it's a different river. However, to have the constant of that river being there, you need this change. You need the constant change of water flow over that spot to be... you need that constant change over that spot to create the river. So to have the river, and the river is a unity because it makes the world work, and it is a unity, it is one, it is solid. However, the river is constantly different water that's running down. Here in air we have the river, and that's not the same river the summer that you went in last summer and this summer coming up. You know, so that's interesting to think about. And so that would also introduce his quote of this drink that they used to drink in ancient Greece, which was made of wine, barley and cheese, and supposedly it was this disgusting drink, and there was oil in it as well. And so it would all separate in this drink. This drink would all separate, and you'd have to stir it. And the quote is, so this drink would be called posset, right? And the quote is, even the posset separates if it has not been stirred. So if you don't stir this drink, the drink begins to separate and goes disgusting. And so that's an interesting thought, is to have that together. So to make this more... like relatable in a sense to us nowadays, look at like a vinaigrette, where you've got the oil and the vinaigrette together, that you're going to put on your salad, and to have that vinaigrette, or that, what's it called, like salad dressing, to have that, you need to mix the two together, to create it. And when you don't, it separates again. And so you need that change for that to be a constant. And he says it's the same with everything. And so he'd say the same about water and fire. And we know that fire represented the soul. So he'd believe of this, I think it was called the inner flux. And that was this burning light, this burning flame inside you. And he said that you can dampen this with water. It's the water is the opposite of it, right? And so the flame is logos, and the water is negative things. And so that's what they resemble. So there was a good quote about an alcoholic, and about how the alcoholic, something I don't remember it and I didn't write it down, but something about how he pities the alcoholic because his flame is dampened by the alcohol, and his flame is dampened, and it's like, it makes sense when you hear it, but like metaphorically, but he meant like there is this thing inside of us that is our soul, and it is dampened by this drink. And so this is really interesting, I thought. And he also had another one, which I thought was really interesting in terms of relationships and such, where he said that the sea is poison to man, but healthy for fish. And so he's saying that there is this cycle. It's not that these two opposites are constantly tugging at each other, although he did say that the war is king of life, or something along those lines. It's not that they're constantly butting, but it's the fact that they're constantly changing between the two that creates this unity. And so by having it poisonous to man but healthy to fish, well then, that's creating that difference and that change. And it's also, it makes me question, I saw a thing before about humans have this incredible thing where we constantly want to label things good or bad. We see a scenario how it happens and we say this is good. We see another scenario how it happens and we say this is bad to us. And I think it's really interesting when you take that, because that scenario might lead to something else that leads to something good. So how can you truly measure if something is good or bad in the end? It's going to be advantageous in some way. And so it's like that. It's poisonous to men. We can't drink water from the sea. However, fish can. So we need to remember that not everything is bad, not everything is good, and that's like the way the universe works, I suppose, this unity of change between everything. Because of these paradoxical comments that he would make, he's retained himself a mystery for years, Heraclitus, with his quote still being interpreted today. The one about the posset that I told you about was recently interpreted by a lecturer, or well, maybe I think 2010, she interpreted it, and she took the ancient Greek words and she retranslated them to a way that maybe that's how they spoke instead. She retranslated the words and made new sense of the words. So I think it's really interesting that this still gets spoke about. If you're interested in it, do get in touch. It's just this sort of idea of this grand unity in life. I suppose it's the Force in Star Wars, it's the Zen and the yin and yang, it's that sort of stuff. So, like, it's interesting to have a think about. So if you're interested, let me know, get in touch. That's the philosophy segment done for tonight, unless you'd like to speak more about it with any of your guys' opinions. But right now you're listening to me, Kyle Livingstone. This is Nocturnal on UWS Radio, 87.7 FM, on DB, and online at uwsradio.scot. Go check out the Facebook page. I think we've got over 50 likes now, which is incredible, so thank you for that. Thank you. Thank you. Can you hear me clapping in my studio all alone, where normally I'd have someone to clap with me? What joy, what joy. Anyway, we're going to have a song on now. Which song will we go with? We're going to go with this song, okay. This is Call You Up by Viola Beach. I saw someone was out listening to it earlier on one of their 30 song challenges. So I thought I'd put this on. It's a very nice one. Enjoy. If you want to get in touch, please do. You know how to. Here's the song. Well, there you go. That was Tado as well there at the end. And before that, it was To the Moon by Juno Dream. I'll say it again. Great song. That needs to be the catchphrase. You're listening to UWS Radio on 87.7 FM. We're also on DAB. And we also go out live online at uwsradio.scot. And right now, would you look at the time? It's already 20 to 1. Time is flying by on this radio show. And I say that every time I do a radio show. Time flies by when you're sat in here listening to music, chatting to people about the show and what's been said today. And it's just been great. You know, my gran got in touch with the show earlier on today. My dad was showing her how she could see or how she could listen into the show. And so she listened in today. And I was very happy with that. It was very nice that my gran listened in. And she spoke about the conversation. We were talking about haggis. And my gran used to be a haggis eating champion, supposedly. So the next time I'm home, I've been told I can get told all about that. She'll explain it then. So very interesting. Wow, I didn't expect that of my grand, to be honest. But there you go. That's what grands are for, right? I was saying the mysteries of Sandra Livingstone. The mysteries. How have you guys been? Get in touch. Let me know. We do have a Facebook page. We're now sat at 60 likes. You guys are crazy. If we've got a lot of people listening just now. Hi. I hope you're doing well. So far we spoke about philosophy, we spoke about nature and what I've seen around. Also, that's what I forgot to mention about the nature. I forgot to mention, there's a lot of wild garlic coming back in the forest around, and you can smell it when you're walking on the forest path. And you can actually go and dig them up. Once they've grown a bit, you can go and dig them up and actually have garlic for in your house that you can eat and use right on our doorstep. There you go. That was the interesting part that I completely forgot my nature update earlier. But I want to speak quickly about what the news me and Lewis missed today that was announced. I want to speak about that a bit. And did you know McDonald's are releasing a new gold card? So it's a VIP pass for people. And the advertisement is gold is the new black. It's McDonald's VIP. Very interesting. So... The Monopoly is coming back to McDonald's like it does every year. They have the Grand Big Macs just now, and then they're going to introduce the Monopoly again. However, this time, when it starts on the 24th of March. This time there's 1,000 of these gold VIP cards up for grab. I thought it was quite appropriate. I spoke about this since me and Lewis hold a lunch hour show, and I managed to miss it. Yeah, 1,000 of these up for grabs, which gets you a full year's worth of free food. So I wonder if it lasts you a year, so if it goes out of date after a year, or... no, it must be that. They won't have calculated how much food someone could have a year, and then limit them to that, like, that many meals. Maybe. I don't think so. But there you go. They're starting. So you can, you know, you can win all the cars and the holidays and stuff with the Monopoly if you get the right ones. And you also get like the small prizes as well that keep you buying, really. And so that starts again on the 24th. And their spokesperson said that gold is the new black. After years of requests, McDonald's is launching a VIP gold card, no Brit Award required. The only way you can get your hands on McDonald's gold card is to play. If Stormzy and Ed Sheeran want to get one, they'll have to play Monopoly. Winners will be able to claim one meal per week with the card. Oh, okay, there we go. And it's been rumored that McDonald's has a gold card for VIP customers. It's been rumored for a while already, but this is them releasing it. So there you go. They've tweeted about it and everything. So quite exciting. Would you want one? Would you want a gold VIP McDonald's card, or would you get put off it? Like, would it just be, no, I don't want McDonald's that much? I thought that was quite an interesting story today. I don't know. Like, I don't eat McDonald's enough, but that would be nice to get one a week. Like, why not? That'd be grand, right? That'd be grand. Another update that me and Lewis always speak about is the Tesco cat. We've heard no more news about the Tesco cat, other than the fact he's probably outside Tesco's doors just now. I mean, hopefully he's in his bed asleep. But I'm sure he's been out of Tesco's doors today. This is a cat down in Norwich called Pumpkin, who likes to do this around Tesco. He broke in, and eventually he got banned. I always bring it up, always. It's a fun story that I always love. But we've also got our own Tesco cat here at Halls called Vinyl, we all call him. His real name's Cookie, though. And he does have owners that stay in air, and he comes and gets picked up by the owners because he comes and harasses everyone at Halls, trying to get into bedrooms, trying to be cuddly with people. And it's very cute, it's very nice, and I think it's great for people to have an animal around. It's very nice. Just an update. I don't think much has been happening with him recently. I've seen him around. There was an update. Lewis was saying that there is a new grey cat walking around, which is interesting. I want to see this grey cat and see what it's like. All kicking off here in air. We've got daffodils coming up, there's cats running around, and Kyle's learning about philosophy. It's all interesting. I'll give you an update about stuff like the music video I'm working on and any work like that. But I never put much time to that. It's not that important. But you're listening to UWS Radio. This is Nocturnal with Kyle. If you'd like to get in touch and join the conversation, come over onto Facebook and let us know what you think. Philosophy, this is the question for tonight. Do we live in a unity? What is a unity? And how is constant change unity? That's what we've been speaking about. And it's been very interesting. So if you've got anything to say on that point, or anything at all, just get in touch, let me know. And now we've got Marinade by Dope Lemon. I've not heard this song in a while. Don't remember what it goes like, but I remember it being good because I remember what the picture looks like. So here you go. Enjoy. There you go, that was Marinade by Dope Lemon. I need to cough quick. I'm just reading here that there's this cat who's got solitary confinement in a cat shelter at the minute. He's put into solitary cat confinement. That was my own joke, I didn't steal that. And so this cat is a repeated offender, and he is letting other cats out of their cages in the shelter. The cat's name is Quilty, and he's been sentenced to solitary confinement, where he's not allowed to touch other cats' cages. And he had a few warnings, however, this time he's had to be put in solitary confinement. And so they realised that they had an issue when there was repeatedly cats out of the room every day. And so they worked out that it was Quilty. And in his past owner in Houston, where they used to own him, he'd let the owner's dog back into the house. When the owner didn't want the dog into the house, the cat would break the dog back in. So there you go. I don't know if that is definitely real or believable. It's from the Mirror. But it's an interesting one. Quilty loves to let cats out of the senior room repeatedly, several times a day. We have since Quilty proofed the cat room while he took a brief hiatus in the lobby. His roommates missed him while he was banished to the lobby. They enjoyed their nighttime escapades around the shelter. So there you go, there's a fun one. A cat has broken out there. Yeah, there you go. A little bit of fun news, more about cats. We do love cats. I love cats over here, anyway. We've got Jared getting in touch with the river theory. He thinks, too, that a person can never stand in the same river twice. Yes, because it's flowing over, but also, are you the same person? Which is a really interesting question to go farther into that. There was also Heraclitus did say something along these lines, or at least it's quoted. There's multiple variants of the quotes because his original writings got lost, and so it's different students transcribing it. And so one of the things he says is he questions that that you can never stand in the same river. But neither, you're not the same man either. And there's this constant change, which I never actually spoke about, but I did have written down to speak about, was like the effect on your mental state as well, is this constant change, and it's this constant stability of you, essentially, I suppose. And also Jared was saying about change, he read somewhere that the only thing that's consistent in life is change, and that it's a bit less cynical than the only inevitable is death, which is pretty cool. Yeah, that's very true. I suppose a consistent thing in life is death as well, and we're told that a lot. But it's a very negative way to look at life. We should be looking at it in a happier way and saying, yes, there's change, there's lots of things happening. And that's the constant in life. That's the unity. It's not death that keeps us together. It's constant change that keeps the physical world together as it is. So there's a little bit of the philosophy. My plan is for next week that we're going to cover that a bit more. I'll probably give you another nature update as well. I'll play more great tunes. Throughout the week, get in touch with the Facebook page, suggest any music, and I can get it on the system for you. We do still have requests for tonight. I'm going to be ending on those. Next week, I'm also going to be doing... I spoke about it 2 weeks ago. is a lo-fi beat will get played, and I'll have a guest that has to rap to it, and it's lo-fi, so it's chill, and so it's like, I've done this before when I've been explaining it to people and made those noises before. It should be good fun. Unfortunately, I can't get them in as live guests, so it will be a pre-recorded segment that we'll cut away to. But it should be great fun just to hear my friends just be around. And you know, get people as part of the show, and you guys that listen as well, come on in, and like, it'll be good fun. Have a little challenge, and we'll keep a leaderboard of who lasts the longest in seconds. If you can rap for 2 minutes straight on this, then you're great. You've beat everyone. But we've got 5 minutes left of the show here. You're listening to UWS Radio with me, Kyle Livingstone, and this is Nocturnal. Head over to the Facebook page if you have any song requests for next week that you'd like to listen to. I'm here from 12 till 1, so we've got 5 minutes left. But head over to the Facebook page, give it a like, give it a comment. Glad to see people getting in touch tonight. And I hope you guys have enjoyed the show so far. Next, I'm going to put on Caledonia by Dougie McLean. I like the song, means a lot personally. So it's on the system. Let's crank it on. And feel Scottish for a bit. I'll come back and I'll say goodbye afterwards, and we'll play the last requested song as well. So here we go, Caledonia by Dougie McLean. So there you go, there's Caledonia by Dougie McLean. I love the song, it's close to heart. So yeah, that's nice. I feel very tired now after that. I think I'm going to be going home now from the uni. I'm going to get myself a nice bowl of shreddies with some sugar. After my talks with Lewis about a nice bowl of cereal at nighttime. Do you agree with that? Do you? I hope you guys have enjoyed our chats today. I hope that we've got more for the show next week. I hope we have the segment. I know there's a good few people that want to get involved and come on the show. So if you do too, just message and we can get it arranged for you to be on the show. Guys, just remember, I just want to spread peace, just want to spread happiness, and be chill, be unity with everything, be one with the changes that come through you and come through your life, no matter what the circumstances. Those changes keep you, and keep you that unity. Remember, you're just as simple as the universe, and the universe isn't simple. So enjoy yourself, be happy, be peaceful. Here we're gonna play the last song for tonight, which is I've completely lost it. It is in here, I promise. It's called "The Hole of the Moon" by the Water Boys. We're putting this on for Brian, so here you go. Have a good night, guys. Look after yourselves. Be good. Be good. But that song ended abruptly. That wasn't meant to happen. Apologies for that. I was going to be staying anime for a wee section, just to speak about the end part of the show. I always like to throw something in afterwards. I'm also going to put in another song just to chill with underneath us. I just want to say thank you if you're still listening just now. Thank you for listening in and enjoying the show. I hope you guys have a good night. Have a great week and a great weekend. You're listening to UWS Radio. This is Kyle Livingstone. I'm signing off for tonight. Have a good one.